एग्जैक्ट डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस, यस, दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द टाइप ऑफ द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विच वी कैन कॉल इट एज फर्स्ट ऑर्डर फर्स्ट डिग्री, राइट? इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन वी आर मोस्टली कंसर्न विद द लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. एंड वॉट डज लीनियर मीन्स? लीनियर मीन्स उस डिग्री इज वन. सो बेसिकली वी आर ट्राइंग टू फाइंड आउट और लर्न द टाइप्स ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस विच आर लीनियर, नो डाउट, बट दे आर ऑल्सो हैविंग फर्स्ट ऑर्डर. सो वी आर मोस्टली डीलिंग विद द फर्स्ट ऑर्डर फर्स्ट डिग्री डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस विच वी कैन कॉल इट एज फर्स्ट ऑर्डर लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. सो इन दैट केस वी हैड डिस्कस्ड द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विच इज डिपेंडेंट विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एज वाई, विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एज एक्स, विच इज रिड्यूसिबल टू लीनियर फॉर्म एक्सेट्रा. So the last form which we are going to talk about is exact differential equation. So as you can all see here, a differential equation which will be expressed of in the form, yeah, which will be written in the form m dx plus n dy is equal to zero. Now see, what are these dx and dy? The dx and dy are nothing but the differentials for the variable x and y. Our combination will always contain dy by dx, right? When y is called as a dependent variable, the differential coefficient is written as dy by dx. So similarly, here also the differentials whichever are available, those differentials are pertaining to the variable x as well as y. So our differential equation will be of the form, or if it is not, we have to bring it to the form m dx plus n dy is equal to 0. Now, what are these m and n? These m and n are functions of x and y, or they might be constants. As you have learnt earlier also, constant can be expressed as per the requirement. Constant can be either taken as variable of x or can be taken as variable of y, right? So, therefore, the choice is here that m and n can be either functions of x and y or they might be constants, is said to be exact if the expression on the left hand side is expressed or is obtained directly by differentiating some functions of xy. So if I say that f of xy is such a function, then how this LHS is obtained? LHS is obtained by directly differentiating the function of xy. That is what they are trying to tell us. So then only we can say that it is exact differential equation. See, integration and derivatives are reverse process of each other. So in exact differential equation, when one side of the equation can be expressed as exact differentiable or exact differential, we call that differential equation as exact differential equation. So in this case, when m dx plus n dy is expressed as complete derivative or complete differential of function of xy, that differential equation will be termed as exact. We try to bring it to the form m dx plus n dy is equal to 0. I hope the definition of exact differential equation or the ultimate mathematical meaning is clear, what we have written. Yes?
Yes, sir.
But every time it is not possible for me to express it into the exact differential. Right. I also don't know that this particular given equation is exact differential of which function. Right. So for that, to check whether the given differential equation is exact or not, the necessary and sufficient condition is given for this particular differential equation, which is del m by del y is equal to del n by del x. So what is del m by del y? Del m by del y is the partial derivative of m with respect to y. What is a del n by del x? It is partial derivative of n with respect to x. Now see, this particular term is a new term for you. What do you mean by partial derivative? Up till now we have discussed ordinary derivatives, right? When y is equal to x square is a particular function, I write down the derivative as dy by dx. Right, and what is the derivative for the value for this dy by dx?
2x.
2x, because derivative of x square is given by 2x. But here I find that y is only a function of x. y is only a function of single variable x, right? So therefore the dependent variable becomes y, independent variable becomes x, and its derivative is written as dy by dx, and the differentiation of x square is written as 2x. But when a function is a function of two or more variables, suppose I write that z is a function of two variables x and y, right? Here it is function of only one variable x. Here z is a function of two variables x and y. Then z can be differentiated with respect to x. Z can be differentiated with respect to y as well, right? So in that case, the derivatives what we write are del z by del x, and the derivative is written as del z by del y, right? So in that case, ordinary derivative d by dx is replaced by del by del x, which is called as partial differential coefficient. The ordinary derivative d is replaced by del, which is the partial differential operator. Did you get the difference between the two? When I
will be
saying it as del z by del x, when z is differentiated with respect to two or more variables, more than one variable. More than one variable means two or more variables. So whenever we are going to take the derivative for two or more variables, the derivative or the differential operator which is involved is no more ordinary derivative, it is partial derivative. Ordinary derivative or operator is denoted by d by dx. Partial derivative operator is denoted by del by del x, or it is denoted by del by del y. Now, z is a function of two variables, x as well as y. Z is a function of two variables, x as well as y. So therefore, del z by del x is the derivative which is involved. Del z by del y is the derivative which is involved. Now the question arises, how these derivatives are to be calculated? I simply know when y is equal to function of x, derivative of x square is going to be 2x. In this case also, the process of calculating the derivative is same. We calculate the derivative one by one or one after the other as per the normal procedure of the calculation of derivative. But while differentiating with respect to one variable, other variable is to be treated as constant. Now suppose I have z is a function of x square plus y square, right? So del z by del x will be one of the derivative, I say partial derivative. So this is derivative to be obtained with respect to variable x. So what about this y? Y will be treated as constant while taking the derivative of x. So what is derivative of x square? It is normal, 2x. But while writing down the derivative of y is constant and derivative of constant is 0. I hope you have got how you calculate the partial derivative with respect to x. Similarly,
yes, sir,
the partial derivative with respect to y. Now, while calculating partial derivative with respect to y, what will be kept constant? Other variables will be kept constant. So what is derivative of x square, which is constant?
Zero.
And what is normal derivative of y square?
2y.
Here we won't multiply by dy by dx because already we are differentiating with respect to which variable? With respect to y. In general, when I have to calculate the derivative of y square, what I write? 2y into dy by dx, because that derivative is to be written pertaining to independent variable x. We are differentiating with respect to x. But here, why I will write only 2y? Because already we are differentiating with respect to the variable y. I hope this concept of partial derivative is clear. So therefore,
yes, sir,
del m by del y means partial derivative with respect to y, keeping all the terms of x as constant. Del n by del x is nothing but partial derivative of n with respect to x, keeping variable y constant. So that is what the notation is for the partial derivative. So every time I need not have to check the condition whether the given differential equation is a exact differential, the exact differential of any function x, y or not. I have to just check the condition of exactness. So the necessary and sufficient condition for the differential equation mdx plus ndy is equal to 0 to be exact is del m by del y is equal to del n by del x. So whenever I come across with the differential equation in this form, it might turn out to be exact provided this condition is fulfilled. If this condition is not equal, then I can say that the given differential equation is not exact differential equation. Now, just to show you that how this is mathematically said that it should be exact differential of a particular function. If you differentiate this a product x into y, what is the product rule? First function into derivative of second plus second into derivative of first. So what is the d of xy? X into derivative of y plus y into derivative of x. So this is called as exact differential equation whose RHS can be written as complete derivative of function xy. And then x dy plus y dx equal to 0 is exact and solution will be given by xy is equal to c. To calculate the solution, we integrate both sides and integration and derivative will cancel. So what is the solution? Xy is equal to c. Because if you differentiate this equation, it will give you d of xy is equal to 0. Derivative of constant is 0. But what is this d of xy? D of xy is nothing but the exact differential which is expressed as mdx plus ndy. So this is just the example wherein you are made exposed to how the differential equation is expressed as exact differential or how it is written as complete differential of any function x, y and what is the procedure for calculating the solution in that case. But very rarely we will be going with this particular form. I have to only check whether the given differential equation is expressed in this form or not. Mdx plus ndy equal to 0. Check the condition of exactness, then I can find out the solution. So this part is clear. How to determine the exact differential equation? What is m? M is function of xy. What is n? N is function of xy or any constant. Therefore, as it is a function of two variables x and y, we calculated the exact, we calculated the partial derivative. Here also, when it is a function of two variables, in case of exact differential equation, we calculated the partial derivative del n by del x. Is this background clear?
Yes, sir. So,
yes, sir.
Though mathematically, it looks very difficult that how the differential equation will be converted to exact and how do you know that which function's exact differential or complete derivative is this? But this is just to tell you mathematically, we are going to check the condition of exactness. Written up to this, this example is written by everybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, condition yes, of sir. Exactness is written?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, remember. Now, this is the point which is applicable to us for identifying the equation, whether it will be linear or reducible to linear or Bernoulli's or exact. So remember, whenever you see such kind of functions or terms, check for exact differential equation first. If not, then see the other forms.
Sir, can you please scroll up for?
Example
sir,
is
some more. Sir, some more scroll up.
What you have not written? Up till where you have finished?
Yes, sir. From this, I have to write. I will take a screenshot and write it later.
the necessary and sufficient condition for the differential equation m dx plus n dy is equal to 0 to be exact is del m by del y. This operator is pronounced as del. Del m by del y is equal to del n by del x. Example, x dy plus y dx is complete differential of xy. Product rule, first into derivative of second plus second into derivative of first. Derivative of x is dx, derivative of y is dy. So this is exact differential equation whose solution is written as xy is equal to c. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Remember, whenever you see f of xy into dx plus f of xy into dy, then check for exact differential equation first. If not, then see the other form. Sometimes, see, if you remember, we have to transfer this particular term on the other side, then divide by dx so that it is convertible to dy by dx or dx by dy. We have done such kind of examples, right? But initially, if you see a form of this kind, first check for exactness. If it is not coming out as exact, then we can try for the other forms. Otherwise, it will be very convenient for us to move ahead with the exact differential equation, because the pattern of writing down the solution is very, very simple or easy. Secondly, mostly the terms in complicated form of function of xy are convertible to m dx plus n dy. So whenever if you see the complicated combination of variable x and y, we can easily try to convert it into the form m dx plus n dy is equal to 0. Once it is obtained as m dx plus n dy is equal to 0, you can identify it as exact, and for exact we can find out the solution of the differential equation. Clear the second point also noted down?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Others completed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Wait for the second point, sir.
Yeah. Method of solving exact differential equation. Write down the method for solving exact differential equation. Now, what is the procedure? I should know. The first point is write the differential equation in the form m dx plus n dy is equal to 0. Verify the condition del m by del y is equal to del n by del x. See, here it is crisscross. M is the coefficient of differential dx which is associated. How to identify m and n? M kiske saath juda rahega? Dx ke saath. What will be n? Whatever is the term associated with dy, that will be n. But derivative lete vakt it is crisscross. Del n by del x and del m by del y. The derivatives are to be taken in the opposite variable. So, method of solving the exact differential equation, number one, write the differential equation in the form m dx plus n dy is equal to 0. Verify the condition del m by del y is equal to del n by del x. Write the solution in the form integration of m dx keeping y constant plus integration terms of n containing only y or terms of n which are free from x whole dy is equal to c. Constant of integration is always to be written as c. It is the case of indefinite integration. So always we will have the constant of integration as C. Is the way of writing solution clear?
Yes, sir.
Integration of M to be done with respect to X. And while integrating with respect to X, Y will be kept as constant. N में से कौन से टर्म्स लेना है जो ओनली Y कंटेन करते हैं? So plus integral of the terms which contain only Y or which are free from X. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So yes, that is sir. How we write down the solution. Now, as I said, constant can also be taken as variable in the form of X or variable in the form of Y. So if you find any constant in the N, you should take it because it is integrable with respect to Y, right? 2, if it is integrated with respect to X, it will give you 2X as the solution. 2, if it is integrated with respect to Y, it will be giving you 2Y as the solution, right? So accordingly, any constant which is contained in N should also be considered as a term of Y. Because it is integrable with respect to Y. Many times student commit mistake over here. This point is very, very important to be remembered. So point number 4, 3 and 4 are important. Any constant containing in N can be term of Y as integral K into dy is equal to K into integration of dy and which is K into Y. I hope you got this point. 2 when integrated with respect to X will give you answer as 2X. If I integrate 2 with respect to Y, it will give you answer as 2Y. So I can consider constant as function of Y. No problem in that. It is justified.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Yes,
sir. Completed up to point number 4.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All of you have written down?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So can we just go through the steps? What is step number 1? What we have to do in the step number 1, express the given differential equation into the form MADX plus NDY is equal to 0. Second, check the condition of exactness. What is it? Del M by del Y is equal to del N by del X. Now see, in condition of exactness, how you determine M? M is the term which will be present or which will be associated with the differential DX. Capital N will be the term which is associated with the differential dy. So I get the value of M as well as N. But while calculating the derivative, it is in the crisscross form. M should be differentiated partially with respect to Y. So while differentiating partially with respect to Y, what is to be kept as constant? X. While differentiating N with respect to X partially, what is to be kept as constant?
Y.
Right? The normal process of differentiation will be carried out, but the other variables are to be treated as constant and write down the derivatives appropriately. Once this condition comes out to be equal, we say that condition of exactness is verified. Only writing the equation in the form does not guarantee that equation is exact. It is just the standard form in which the equation is to be converted. But condition of exactness is this, which is to be checked every time. If this is found valid, then solution will be written as integral M dx, keeping Y constant. While integration also, Y will be kept as constant. Only the terms of X are to be integrated. Plus integral terms of N containing only Y dy. or the terms which are free from x that will be integrated with respect to y is equal to constant. In addition to this, this point is important. Any constant which contains any constant which is appearing in n should be also considered as term of y, right? So that is how the method of solving the given differential equation is to be implemented by looking at the question. Example number one, show that e to the power y plus 1 into cos x dx plus e to the power y into sin x dy is equal to 0 is exact, and solve it. In this example, they have said clearly that show that it is exact differential equation and then solve it. So here the condition of exactness should come out as valid. Note down the question. Write down the terms properly. Show that e to the power y plus 1 multiplied by cos x dx plus e to the power y into sin x dy is equal to 0 is exact, and solve it. Given differential equation is e to the power y plus 1 cos x dx plus e to the power y into sin x dy is equal to 0. Equation number 1. Completed with the question?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Now, it is given in the standard form. I need not have to convert it into the mdx plus ndy form. So directly I can find out certain terms which are associated with the differential dx, certain terms which are associated with the differential dy. So comparing it with m dx, m is nothing but what? Function of xy dx plus n function of xy dy is equal to 0. We get m is equal to what it will be? E to the power y plus 1 into cos x. What will be n? E to the power y into sin x, comparing with m dx plus n dy, right? That is the standard form. M dx plus n dy is equal to 0. From that only I can compare the value for m as well as n. It should be equated with 0 first, then only I can get the value of m and n. Note it down up to this.
Yes, sir.
Now don't write anything, just first understand the derivative, because this concept is new for you, right? Del m by del y, I have to differentiate this m partially with respect to y. As I said, the way of calculating the derivative or the process of calculation of derivative will be usual. Only the other variable is to be treated as constant. Now while differentiating partially with respect to y, which variable is to be kept constant? X. Cos x will be constant. Write it as it is. And now concentrate on differentiating this term. Derivative of e to the power y plus 1. Derivative of 1 will be 0. Derivative of e to the power y will be e to the power y. Cos x constant. So complete derivative del m by del y is e to the power y into cos x. I hope this is clear.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Now, from the term n, I have to differentiate this with respect to x, means e to the power y or the term of y should be kept constant. So that is written as it is. Concentrate on this term. What is derivative of sin x? Derivative of sin x is cos x. So what answer you are getting over here? Del n by del x is e to the power y into cos x. Are these two values equal?
Yes, sir.
Del m by del y is equal to del n by del x. The condition of exactness is verified, and hence the given differential equation is exact. Yes, note down the steps, please. Kindly speak while writing down. While differentiating with respect to y, x will be constant, cos x as it is. Derivative of e to the power y plus 1. Derivative of e to the power y. Derivative of 1, 0. Condition of exactness is verified. So the terms associated with dx are to be taken as m. Terms associated with dy are to be considered as n, whatever is the differential equation given. By for the condition of exactness, I have to differentiate m with respect to y. I have to differentiate n with respect to x. So while differentiating partially with respect to y, x will be kept as constant. So cos x is constant. Derivative of e to the power y plus 1. Derivative of e to the power y. Derivative of 1 is 0. So you get the answer as e to the power y cos x. Del n by del x, while differentiating partially with respect to x, y to be kept as constant. So e to the power y is constant as it is. Derivative of sin x is cos x. So del n by del x is e to the power y cos x. So from the by observation or by looking at the terms, I find that both the terms are equal. So del m by del y is equal to del m by del x. It is called as del. Del by del x is the differential operator. Del by del y is the differential operator. Ordinary derivative, we write down d by dx. D by dy. Right? This is the differential operator. Ye x ke upar jayega. Ye y ke upar jata hai. This will be on z. Z is a function of xy. It is differentiable. So the condition of exactness is verified. Hence, the given differential equation is exact. Completed up to this?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, any difficulty? Has everybody got this? What we are trying to do?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Others? Yes, sir. Abin is yes, saying, sir. Can you explain the comparing step? Did you understand, Abin? Is it clear now or still you have any doubt? Comparing step means getting the values or extracting the values for m and n, right? So whatever function of xy capital M, it is coefficient of dx, the terms associated with dx. Also mind well, in the standard form here it is plus m dx plus n dy. If you find the term as minus, it should be absorbed in n. You remember? So n kaise lena hai? Minus ke saath lena hai if the standard form is not fulfilled. Right? Did you get what I'm trying to tell you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So hence the given differential equation is exact. The solution is given by, write down the solution, integration m dx keeping y constant plus terms of n containing only y dy is equal to c. Do not forget to write this c on the RHS. This
sir, step of just a bit scroll up. Yes.
Condition of exactness ke baad aapko ye term likhna zaruri hai solution ka always. That is very very important. Right? Every time you have to write it for your understanding.
Yes, sir, it's done.
Done. So integral m dx keeping y constant plus terms of n containing only y dy is equal to c. Now what is m? M was e to the power y plus 1 into cos x, right? So that is all completely to be integrated with respect to x. But mind well, what is to be kept constant while this integration?
Y.
And other obvious other terms will also be constant, which are already the constant terms. Terms of n containing only y. Now what is n over here? N given to us, or n which is found out, is e to the power y into sin x. Now the term of y is, the term containing variable y is e to the power y. The term containing variable x is sin x. This is what we have seen while differentiation, right? But this is a combination which appears in the product form. So can we extract the term? No. See, whenever you are writing down the function as x into y, into means it is a combined term, right? So I cannot say that this is x is a function of x and y is a function of y. It is completely the product xy. But yes, if I use the binary operator, I can say that this is a separate term, this is a separate term. I hope you understand what I'm trying to tell you. Whenever there is a multiplication or division, this complete term is treated as one whole term. But the moment we introduce the binary operator plus or minus, the terms are separated. In the higher classes or the middle school level, I think you have come across with the definition binomial, trinomial, polynomial. Yes. So binomial means the term which contains two different, the expression which contains two different terms. Trinomial means the expression which contains three different terms. But how those are identified? The terms are identified by the separation of the binary operator. Plus and minus are always taken as treated as binary operator, because if I introduce plus in between x, y, it will be separated into two. It, if it is not containing any of the by operation or operator in between, it is product. And product and division gives you as a whole term. It cannot be separated. So the point of contention to tell you this here, e to the power y sin y appears in the product form. Though it is containing e to the power y, but it cannot be separated from sin x as an independent term of y. Aayi kya baat samajh mein? Agar,
yes, sir.
If it would have been e to the power y plus sin x, I would have separated the term of e to the power y from the given n as an independent term of y, or the term which is free from x. This particular expression, I cannot say that it is completely independent of x. It is involving x in it, because e to the power y sin x is as a whole term. It is not, it cannot be taken as a two different terms. If you get this particular difference or understanding proper, then there will be no problem. So there is there any term of y which is containing in n? No,
no.
Because that cannot be separated. So we take it as zero. And what is integration of zero? Zero. So write down for or note down for your understanding. Terms in combination of multiplication / division cannot be separated, but of addition and subtraction. Right? Noted down this step.
So please wait a second.
Integral e to the power y plus 1 into cos x dx keeping y constant plus, there is no such term which is free from x or which is completely independent of x or which contains purely y. Because in the given example, it is a combination and I cannot separate that. So I take it as 0 dy is equal to c, which will be constant of integration. Terms in combination, this you note down for your understanding or remembrance. terms in combination of multiplication / division cannot be separated, but if they are in addition and subtraction, we can consider them separately for as a function of x or function of y. Right? Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Now concentrate on this integration part. Y is constant, 1 is also constant, so this complete bracket is constant. Take it outside the integral, because integration is only to be done with respect to x. Clear?
Yes, sir.
This whole term, whichever is constant, is written outside. Integration of cos x is sin x. So this is what the expected answer is. In the bracket, you write down e to the power y plus 1 multiplied by sin x is equal to c is the required solution. This complete term is constant. Y is constant. 1 is also constant. Take it outside the integration.